During the Thatcher years, there was a public inquiry into every major disaster. Zeebrugge, Clapham Junction, Piper Alpha, King's Cross, Hillsborough. The one exception was the sinking of the Marchioness by the Bow Belle.
Of all the public tragedies in that decade of disasters, this one seemed to receive the least public pity. For all of you here, and for many more who were associated with the disaster and were worried by its implications, there has long been a heavy sense of unfinished business, of truths yet to be told, of justice yet to be done.
Well done, Stephen. 7/10 faster than your previous best.
And of a real assurance yet to be given that the same thing couldn't happen again. As we were planning this service, that was the chief misgiving. How could we dare speak of closure and healing?
Francesca? Hi.
When so much seemed to remain unresolved.
There you go, Julie. All ready for ironing.
Oh, thanks, Nick. I don't know what I'd do without you.
You'd probably have to buy a washing machine for your flat.
We can only move on from a basis of truth. It is only by confronting the truth of what happened on that terrible night that we can hope for any good to come.
Quite a Foster's, please, mate.
Hey, that's on that one, didn't it?
All right, Bob, what are you having?
Same.
Do you have anyone?
No, come and join me if you like. We've got a good couple of hours yet.
Nice. Some of that.
Hope you're not driving.
Not love out of kip. Just fill it up, man.
Around the way there. Hello, madam. How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
We've got enough ballast on to sail yet, Skip?
No, we'll continue taking on water as we go.
Good. Wouldn't want to get stuck under Tower Bridge.
Woolwich.
Bow Belle.
Yeah, just sing another Metro Greenham Nine Elms.
Draft 3.2, exemption 230, over.
Bow Belle, roger, thank you.
And we'll be back early hours of Monday morning, over.
Ropes away, Captain.
This is PLA Woolwich Control, all ships.
It's navigational information. The Bow Belle singling up from Metro Greenham Nine Elms and shortly to be proceeding through bridges.
Woolwich Radio, Bow Belle Vauxhall Bridge outwards.
Round through there, you got the bar and the disco area.
Bow Belle Vauxhall Bridge outwards, thank you.
See you up, Skipper. If you need me, I'll be at the forecastle talking to Terry, all right?
Nice quiet evening.
Oh, I'll drink to that.
Bye, Skip.
Birthday boy.
Thank you, Magda. Oh, don't spill it.
Don't be shy,
bon
fill
voyage.
It up.
Thank you very much. Got an interest in a sandwich, anybody?
I'm all right, but this is Sophie.
So nice. Help yourself.
Thanks. I had no idea Antonio knew so many people. Who are they all?
Well, some special friends, some acquaintances that may become special friends, some total strangers just to make up the numbers, and a sprinkling of jumped-up suburban housewives.
Right, there you go.
Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thanks very much, Ian.
Oh, it's my pleasure, Elsa. And how's the birthday boy? Haven't had a chance to talk to him tonight.
Oh, Antonio's fine. Very happy. Sorry, excuse me.
What's that for?
This card represents this young man. It's a significator.
See you later, significator.
Now, come on, lads. Let Jackie tell Matthew his fortune.
Oh, I wonder what's coming your way.
I think I can tell you that, and I don't need the cards.
Even Jonathan starts smiling.
He's organised a tarot fortune teller for you.
Really? Let's go and find out what my future holds for me.
Come on then.
Woolwich Radio. Bow Belle approaching Waterloo Bridge outwards. Bow Belle, Waterloo Bridge out.
I couldn't help noticing. You've got fantastic posture. I just wondered.
Thanks. Well, I'm a dancer, so the ballet exercises help. Oh, what do you do?
Oh, well, it depends what day of the week it is, actually. I'm a child's nurse, but I do a bit of waitressing with the extra dosh. Are you with anyone here, or...?
Yeah, with a group of friends. How about you?
Oh, I'm on my own.
Oh, well, stay with us. Then we can join the others when you're finished.
Oh, okay, thanks.
We ate earlier, so.
My God, Vincent, you've done enough to feed an army.
Yeah, all this will vanish, you'll see.
After all that, you gone with the jeans then?
Perhaps I should have been the blue dress.
Oh, no, I think you're right. You look great. And besides, it'll be cold on the river later.
Yeah, Fran, you look perfect.
Thank you.
You look after her, John. And make sure no one slips anything into her drink.
Oh, she watches too many gangster movies. Antonio Vasconcello says something in the city, Mum. Not the white slave trade. John will look after me, so don't worry.
Woolwich control to all boats. The Bow Belle is presently outward bound through bridges and repeating the tide at 4.1 metres above chart datum.
Right, Steve. Do you want anything?
Nah, I'm fine, thanks, mate.
Fucking hell, he's gonna hit it.
Andy, stick your head out and check a stern, would you?
Please, emergency. Pleasure boat is sunk. Cannon Street Railway Bridge. All emergency aid, please.
Calling Thames Police Wapping from Woolwich. Thames Police Wapping from Woolwich. Yeah, pleasure boat sunk at Battersea Road Bridge. It was very muffled, but that's what I got here.
Cannon Street Railway Bridge. Marchioness is sunk. Bow Belle just sunk her.
Fuck!
I'll try and get through.
Oh, I'm getting cold. I lost all my clothes getting out of the boat. People kept grabbing at me, tearing at my clothes. I can't be long before we're rescued.
We've got to get the boat over to those people. Tell the captain we've got to try and save them.
Sort her off to Marshall.
Wait! I said you're gonna turn this fucking boat.
Go back!
Through the bridge!
King's Cross pound.
Oh, that's good.
Good? Good. What the bloody hell's good about that?
It's better than it being stolen.
Come on. Let's get this stuff back to the flat and then I'll go and pick up the car.
First a ticket, then the car pound. These things happen in threes. Probably find the party's been cancelled.
Have you seen Thompson?
Look! Is that her?
Tammy! Tammy, get over here!
It's Erica! I haven't seen Tammy! Jonathan! Jonathan, are you all right?
Erica! Erica! I'm okay. Are you all right?
Yes! Keep a lookout for Tammy!
England! Are you okay? Pass that barrel over here. Let me hang on to it. England, you bastard!
He's gonna nail every fucking one of you to the courtroom wall.
Hello, Jonathan.
You me?
Well done.
Unbelievable.
Come on, grab a piece of wood.
This is supposed to be a vacation.
Oh, do be quiet for a moment, Miles, please. See you later, Jonathan. Bye.
West Thames Police, Wobbin. Marchioness is sunk. Did you understand the message?
Yes, we did get that. We'll get everybody available that we can.
Thank you.
make
come
it.
Come on, Annette. Come on.
That's it. Keep it going.
It's all right. Come on.
No.
What's that, Annette?
Hello, Woolwich. This is the Royal Princess. My position is Waterloo Bridge, outward bound. May I assist in the Mayday?
Yes, Royal Princess. We have a garbled message. We believe it is Battersea Bridge. Can somebody confirm?
I believe it's Cannon Street. It's the Bow Belle Dredger. It's outward bound to Cannon Street.
Yes. Roger. Bow Belle, we have a Mayday. We believe that it's in the region of Battersea Bridge. The Marchioness is sunk.
Woolwich Bow Belle. It's Cannon Street. Cannon Street Bridge here. We're in the centre arch of Cannon Street now, sir. And it's this pleasure boat we didn't see, sir.
Yes, Roger. You struck the pleasure boat. Is that correct, Bow Belle?
Woolwich Radio, Royal Princess. Waterloo Bridge outward bound, full speed to assist in the Mayday.
Woolwich Radio, Bow Belle.
Yes, Bow Belle, Woolwich.
I have to get underway now and proceed out through bridges. I believe I've struck a pleasure craft. It is sunk. I'm getting clear of the bridges now. I was distracted by flashing lights from another pleasure craft. My vessel was proceeding outward bound, just approaching Cannon Street bridges, and I just lost steerage. And I don't know after that. I can't really say anything else, sir. Over.
Yes, Bow Belle. Can you confirm there were people on the pleasure boat?
Yes, sir. There were. The pleasure craft was full. The Royal Princess, I believe, and the Hurlingham are proceeding to its assistance now.
Royal Princess, I'm Southwark Bridge outward bound. I believe there are 125 people on board. That's a rough estimate, sir.
Roger, understood. 125 people on board.
Woolwich Radio from Thames Police receiving.
Thames Police 6, Woolwich.
I didn't get any of that message. Could you... Is it something that concerns us, over?
All available boats, please proceed Cannon Street Railway Bridge. The Bow Belle has struck. The pleasure cruiser Marchioness believed 125 people on board and reported the Marchioness sinking.
Right, received.
Thames Police Wapping Woolwich.
Have we got a definite location for this incident? We're getting confused reports. Over. Yeah, railway bridge. Roofs and have lifeboats.
Scotland Yard Information Room. We have a full emergency. Yes. Yes, initially incident thought to be at Battersea Bridge. Getting reports of survivors in the Blackfriars Bridge area now. Okay.
Woolwich Radio. Thames Police 106. This is a full emergency. Get me any help you can.
106, Woolwich Roger. What else do you require? Any ambulance anywhere? Oh, and where will people be landing?
Radio, pleasure vessels in the area, sir. Assist in rescuing people from the water. From the wreckage, please. That's what we want, first of all.
Radio with Pan message. All vessels are requested to go to the vicinity of Cannon Street and Blackfriars Rail, where people are in the water. Say again, all vessels requested to proceed to Cannon Street and Blackfriars Rail, where people are in the water. This is Woolwich Radio.
Yes, Wapping. Right. We've received a message on your marine set of an incident at Battersea Bridge. Boat sinking after a collision.
Come in, Thames Paul.
Yep. Pleasure boat sunk in vicinity of Southwark Bridge. Got it. Unknown number in the water.
Incident at Battersea Bridge, Tommy. Can you get fire brigade and ambulances running?
Yeah, got it. Already been logged. Hello, Croydon Control. Pleasure boat sinking with 21 people on board. Chelsea Embankment near Battersea Bridge. Yeah, probably the north side. Thank you. Hello, Central Control. We need ambulances immediately to Battersea Bridge.
Thames Unit TP 106, Inspector. They report hundreds of people in the water.
Right. Dispatch a control van to Waterloo Pier to act as forward rendezvous point for incident. Hello? Yeah, ASC Rescue Plymouth. Yeah, we've got a major disaster situation here.
We just survived the boat wreck on the Thames.
You're soaking wet. My car will get messed up.
This is an emergency, for God's sake.
Well, in that case, phone the emergency services.
There are over 100 people down there fighting to stay alive. I think the emergency services might be tied up for a while.
Well, all right. I'll take you to the hospital, but it'll cost you £10 in advance.
I don't know. My two brothers were on the boat. I haven't seen them yet.
Well, how many were on the boat?
Between 100 and 150, I guess. It's my brother's birthday party. You a police officer?
No, I'm a reporter.
Porter.
So, who was on this boat?
Oh, listen, just forget it, okay?
Well, what's your name?
I've got two brothers missing. I've got nothing to say to you. Well, let us in, please, please.
What's up, Gov?
Someone's fucked up, mate. They've sent us the wrong way. The boat's downriver at Southwark Bridge, not here at Battersea. Go to Southwark.
Guys, go to Southwark. To Southwark Bridge. Not here, it's in Southwark.
Have you any idea what time it is? Jesus. Any casualties? Have they been drinking? Had any of the crew been drinking? Have they spoken to anyone? Have the police arrived? Is there any drink on board? Right, I'm away. Now, listen. If Henderson calls again, tell him to talk to me before he talks to anyone else. And if they change berth, ring me on the mobile. You got the number? Yeah. Christ, what a mess. What a fucking mess.
Hey!
him! Got my hand!
Please,
go back! No, you've got to! Come on! You've got to!
Please.
It's the second time you've heard Big Bang.
We've been alone for so long. We're going to drift out to sea and drown.
No, we're not going out to sea. The tide's taking us further inland. We've been under at least three bridges. Come on.
It's so cold. So cold. I lost all my clothes.
There's a boat. There's a boat. Are we saved?
KW31 from the senior ambulance officer and scene. Can we use police vehicles to ferry the injured and the survivors to hospital as they're running low on ambulances?
Affirmative.
Too hot for jackets.
Oh, if you'd been in that water that length of time, you wouldn't be sweating. Oh, my God. Oh, my leg hurts.
Help! We've been waiting here for more than half an hour.
Help! Help! Please help!
Bloody marvellous. We escaped death by drowning only to die of hypothermia.
Simon? I don't care if I'm interrupting you in the middle of shagging Miss World. Get your ass down to Charing Cross Pier. We've got a boatload of rich kids and models gone belly up in the Thames. Yeah, I'm talking maybe 3-4 pages. And I need them filled.
Inspector?
Based on
some information from a known and reliable source connected with the pleasure boat industry, the Marchioness was carrying a party of 120 homosexuals and lesbians. Consequently, there is a high risk of AIDS contamination for all officers and emergency services dealing with victims of a disaster. Every precaution should be strictly taken and adhered to.
Right, move as quickly as you can.
Who was actually throwing the party? Are you one of the models?
Anyone from the Hurlingham or the Marchioness not needing medical attention, please make your way to the Savoy Hotel. Police officers are waiting there to take your statement.
Who was paying for the party? Is it true the captain of the Marchioness was drunk?
Who told you that? No one was drunk. You'd only been sailing for about 20 minutes.
Please don't block the gangway, madam.
Some
of you will be taken to St. Thomas's, the other is Westminster. Dave, which of the two hospitals are you scheduled to go to? Fine, mate. Right, are we ready to go here, yeah?
Hey, my girlfriend, Tammy, Tams and Cole, has anyone of that name been taken to casualty?
She may have gone to either one of the hospitals. Look, when you get to casualty, ask them to phone around.
Okay, thank you. I'll do that.
Can I help you to the ambulance?
No, I'm fine.
Right, as quickly as you can now. This one's going to St. Thomas's.
I'm looking for my girlfriend, Francesca Delalio. Do you know if she's been taken to one of the hospitals?
Best to ask at St. Thomas's. A casualty would check for you.
Thanks. Oh, this is it. What did you mean by that?
I was going to die.
I can't swim.
So just tell us exactly what was going through your mind at the time. Did you feel like this is the end?
No, I was just... Well, there was water everywhere and there were people swimming and everyone was just screaming, really.
Thank you. Cut. Okay, guys, come on, let's go.
What have you got there?
Yes, particularly Nadia Aldridge and Julie Ibbotson. We got some stunning pics of them.
Yeah, I'd like some quotes. That one. Keep that. No, not you, her. You keep that one. Yeah, as soon as you can, Simon.
Ambulances are off on the road. Got glass in my feet and glass in my backside. How do you think I'm going to get up there?
I don't know, love. I've got one or two bigger problems at the moment.
Oh, well, that's charming, isn't it?
No, don't worry, love. We'll take you. Right,
come on.
Okay.
We better wait, please.
Chap, ready mixed concrete?
Yeah. Are you taking me over to the Bow Belle?
That's right, upping.
No sort of fight in me while I was underwater because I was just thinking, well, there's no point. I was in considerable pain because something was trapping me. I remember thinking, look, just open your mouth and swallow. It won't hurt, just like going into a coma. This tearing pain in my chest will stop and I'll just drift away. I didn't feel any panic, just a kind of serene calmness. It sounds poncy, ridiculous. I had some vague, out-of-body experience, face-to-face with myself. It was just like having a mirror in front of me, and with that image, with this calmness. experience altogether. I thought, right, I've got to get out of here. Trust you to organise a party on a fucking boat, Faye.
The boat was Antonio's idea.
If he's still alive, remind me to tell him he's had better ideas. Which hospital are they taking us to?
St. Thomas's.
It's only over the bridge. What's keeping him?
Don't worry, Ian. I'm sure Tammy's safe. How on earth did it happen? How did it happen?
I don't know how long we've got until the police get here. But when they do, you keep your fucking mouth shut. You got that? You keep your fucking mouths shut. We are in very deep and serious shit. Is there any drink on board?
Not that I know of.
There better not be.
Look, Mr. Butcher, we can't just refuse to cooperate with the police. We'll have to give an account.
Of course you will. But not until we know exactly what that account is. Now, I want to go over this ship from top to bottom, from bow to stern. Make sure everything is shipshape and correct. Who the fuck is that?
That's a cook.
Double check for booze. Very carefully.
Being rich means having someone else doing the weekend shopping.
These things happen in threes.
Probably find the party's been cancelled.
Tammy! Tammy! Tammy!
I understand, but there's only...
You've seen it on the news? That's right. We're on this boat for a late-night party down the Thames. Look. There's no easy way for me to say. It's just I haven't seen David since the boat sank. Has he phoned home by any chance? Hang on.
This David? One of the male models, was he?
What?
Was he one of the male models?
Model? No, he was a caterer.
Right.
Hello, are you still there?
What type of food was he serving on the boat?
No, don't cry. I'm sure he'll be fine. He was such a strong swimmer. I mean, is. He is such a strong swimmer. Stay there.
What about the food? You must remember what type of food it was if he was your mate.
I dived off and was taken by the tide. I allowed the tide to take me and it took me through and underneath and out the other side.
What happened to the other people on the boat, did you know?
I didn't look back. And we don't really. It's not clear, really.
And how long were you in there?
I can't find Tammy.
Have you seen her? Do you know where she is?
Lino! See, Lino, I can't find him, Annette!
Look, you must come for treatment. We need to give you an anti-tetanus and you also need treatment for hypothermia.
Is there any survivors? My God, so many are missing. So many are not here. There's more reporters than survivors.
Don't worry, your friends will be at one of the other receiving hospitals.
Yeah, that'll be it. Come on, Nadia, we're going to ring round.
Just a couple more questions.
No, please.
Come on.
No!
One moment we were on the Marchioness, telling each other of how much we loved each other. And the next we were in the Thames. The boat was sinking and we were praying that we would be rescued. Who's coming to this?
Don't be silly. Look, John, we have to call Fran's parents.
Just be praying that any minute she'd just walk in here.
I'll ring Dad. Okay? He'll know what to do.
Hello. Yes, hello.
Look, he's told you we've been involved in a very bad accident on the Thames. The old Bill sent us up here and told us to wait till they take our statements.
You're having us on. How come he's all soaking wet? You've been out on the piss and thought you'd have a lark at the Savoy, that's it, isn't it?
Listen, mate, we've got better things to do than ponce around this wanky hotel. Now, you can open up or what?
No, not dressed like that and dripping water everywhere. If the police sent you up here, then you'll have to wait outside until they turn up.
Nice. It's fucking charming. Come on, boys, let's go. I'm not coming here for my stag party.
Yeah. Okay, thanks. I haven't seen Tammy or Lena.
Okay, we've run every friend and relative we can think of. We've run Guy's and Westminster. Is it possible they've taken them to another hospital, Ian?
It's possible, but those two are the most likely ones. Look, you must go and get your injuries attended to and get tetanus jabs.
I don't want
to
bother with any treatment until my girlfriend and Nadia's boyfriend turn up, okay? But if you agree to carry on checking with Scotland Yard and everyone else, we'll go and get our jabs. Is that a deal?
All right. Give us the details.
It's called Townsend Cole, C-O-L-E.
Can you tell us the number of fatalities there have been in this traffic?
We've got a major situation going on here. There's a lot of young kids involved. It's horrific.
Really horrific.
Excuse me? Excuse me. I'm looking for my daughter, Elsa Gathier McGalvey. Elsa was on the boat that went down in the Thames.
I've no one of that name. Perhaps she's been taken to one of the other hospitals.
I'll go and see.
There's no need. We can call for you.
Her boyfriend, Roberto Martinez, he told me she was here.
Yes, we have a Roberto Martinez, but not your daughter. Sit down, have a rest, have a cup of tea, and I'll call around for you.
You are so kind, but you are also so very busy. I will get the names of these other places from you, and then perhaps this kind man, he will take me.
Perhaps I can help. Is your daughter a model? If she was, my paper could publish some pictures of her. Maybe someone will recognise her.
I don't understand how that will help. She's not lost. I know exactly where she was. She was on the Marchioness. Esso is not a model. She's a university graduate with a BA degree. She's multilingual. And she is the personal assistant of Antonio Vasconcelos. Why do you want to publish photographs of models?
Signal's crap. Anyway, say it again.
Examination room, around the corner. Good news. Your girlfriend's turned up. She's fine.
Oh, below there.
I'll go and fetch her. Back in a minute.
Thank God. Thank God.
I'm so pleased for you.
Thanks.
That's what she said her name was.
Oh, I said I was looking for Tamsin Cole. I'm her sister Pippa.
It should have been the dawn that marked the end of the perfect summer party. Instead, sunrise brought realization that the Thames had suffered one of its worst ever shipping tragedies. The pleasure cruiser Marchioness had simply disappeared.
Mm-hmm.
Within minutes, over 100 yep. excited partygoers pitched into the icy water.
Well, I thought you'd like to know she's cutting short her holiday. Coming back today. What? Well, it's this dreadful business on the river, of course. Public inquiry. No decision on that as yet. Well, yes, I expect she'll be meeting about that aspect later today.
Early this afternoon, the Prime Minister joined the flotilla of boats on the scene. She heard that there were still slim hopes of finding more survivors.
I heard about it first thing this morning. My reaction is the same as everyone else's. Young people. A tragedy, really, of the first order.
Anyone here on behalf of Stephen Pokes and Julie Hunt?
Julie was wearing an orange halter neck, sleeveless top, blue denim cut-off jeans, black tights with bows.
Was she wearing any jewellery, Mrs. Hunt?
She always wore a particular ring on the third finger of her right hand. It had black and white stones in it. Julie will probably be carrying her Fiat car keys, her credit card, and her front door keys. And, oh, her ears are pierced. And officer?
Mrs. Hunt, please call me Becky.
Becky, if my daughter has died, will you please note down that I insist on personally identifying her when she's found? I need to see my child.
I think that's everything, Mr. Perks. I'll see that this information is passed immediately to the major incident room.
Well, have they found my brother?
I have no information on that, I'm afraid. Are you all right to get home on your own?
Yeah, sure. Except I can't remember where I parked the car. I can't even remember how I got here. I remember stopping by one of the bridges and looking into the river. And
where are your parents?
In Bournemouth, visiting Grandad. I didn't want Dad driving back with this on his mind. I decided to wait till they get home to tell them. Well, you never know. We might have had some good news by then. He might be in one of those hospitals.
Yes, I'm sure he will be.
Cup of tea, love?
I'll make it, see if you can catch the news. Oh, it's good to be back home. That was a long drive.
Sunrise brought realization that the Thames had suffered one of its worst ever shipping tragedies. The pleasure cruiser Marchioness had simply disappeared. Helicopters and police launches arrived to find survivors screaming for help in the darkness.
Marie, come and have a look at this.
Other pleasure boats were among those who risked their own lives to help.
There's a pleasure boat being sunk on the Thames. Looks like a lot of youngsters gone down with it.
That's dreadful. When did this happen?
89 survivors were pulled from the freezing water, most badly shocked, but with only minor injuries.
Anthony, come and look at this. It's been a terrible accident on the Thames. Pleasure boat sunk with God knows how many people on it.
Throughout the morning, repeated sweeps of the river continued, police desperately trying to establish how many were still missing. Tired eyes scanned the water from bridges and the muddy banks as that figure rose from 30 to nearly 60.
What is
it? On the scene, accident investigators were already piecing together the moments before the collision. Information which brought them here to the huge sand dredger Bow Belle. Eyewitnesses said she'd hit the stern of the Marchioness, driving her down under the huge bow. But by early evening, hopes were dashed as the Marchioness was lifted slowly to the surface. And within half an hour of the lift, the first body had been recovered. 27 more would take the short journey to the temporary mortuary at Wapping.
right. Listen, it's not going to be a public inquiry. She's announced there'll be an internal inquiry instead. MAIB. The Marine Accident Investigation Branch. Well, you know what she's like. Very hands-on.
Was she wearing any jewellery, Mrs. Hunt?
She always wore a particular ring on the third finger of her right hand. It had black and white stones in it. Like a tea or a coffee, perhaps?
No, thank you, Mrs. Hunt.
Well, sit down.
Sit. Mrs. Hunt, we have some information about your daughter, Julie.
You found her body, haven't you?
Yes. She was found under London Bridge on Tuesday at about 1:40 p.m.
That's 2 days ago.
We wanted to be positive about identification before we contacted you.
Identification? I told your colleague Becky that I would personally identify Julie. Can I see her now?
I assume you've come to make arrangements for the funeral service.
Yes. But before I do that, I wish to prepare Julie.
Prepare?
Yes. With the help of my friends.
Ah, I see. Well, there's no need, Mrs. Hunt. We'll take care of everything.
I come from Trinidad. It is the custom in my country to prepare the dead ourselves. To dress them, prepare them, lay them out, so that relatives and friends may come and mourn.
I'm sorry, viewing your daughter's body is not an option. The coffin has been sealed by the police. I'm afraid you're not to see Julie, so dressing her or making her up is out of the question. She's to be buried as she is.
The police told me that I would be able to see her here.
But her remains are sealed inside a plastic bag. You can, of course, have any coffin of your choice. Perhaps I can show you.
Please. Please. This is very important to me.
Mrs. Hunt, her condition will cause you great distress.
At least let me just hold her hand and sit with her for a while.
Mrs. Hunt, there are no hands.
What I don't understand, Becky, is how the police were able to give me back Julie's ring if her hands were cut off in the accident. That's why I've come to see you again. Can you explain that to me, please? Did they find her hands in the Thames?
I'm so sorry, Mrs. Hunt. In Julie's case, it shouldn't have happened. It wasn't necessary.
Wasn't necessary?
The hands were cut off to assist identification.
All you had to do when you found her body was try the car keys to her Fiat or the door keys to the front door of her apartment. I insisted to you 2 days before you began to mutilate her body. Let me see her, I said. I told you I wanted to personally identify her. You had her full medical history.
details of her doctor, her dentist. What kind of people are you? It's not enough that she died, that her young life, so full of promise, has ended. You mutilate her dead body.
Mrs. Hunt, it was sanctioned by the coroner purely to assist in the identification. In your daughter's case, it was in fact not needed. What happened to Julie's body after it was recovered should never have occurred. My colleagues and I deeply regret that you've been put through any further unnecessary anguish.
What about the other mothers and fathers? The other families? Becky tells me that 25 of those who died had their hands removed for fingerprinting, yet only two of them were identified that way.
Yes.
Most of those poor people were identified from their dental records.
Yes. I am aware of that. Mrs. Hunt, we need your help. None of those other families know about this. Many of the other mothers are already showing signs of cracking under the strain. And we are deeply concerned about their reaction if they learn about these amputations. Please, I beg you, would you please keep this confidential? There's nothing to be gained by telling them, possibly a great deal to lose. It could tip some of them over the edge. I'm asking this not for the sake of the police force, but for the sake of the other parents.
For the sake of the other parents, I say nothing. But I promise you this. I will not rest until the truth is established.
Job. Look, Ian, I know how hard this is. We're all grieving for Tamsin and the others. But can you call me? Please.
We were young people in a hurry. Plan to marry, of course. Plan to have a family. But that was all in the future. That was all sometime later. We didn't know there'd never be sometime later.
Sweet tears roll like a river from your eyes. Get close, let's sleep tonight.
United them as a group is that they were fun-loving, successful, and affluent. As well as their grieving families, lovers, and friends, they have left behind them ranks of Golf GTIs sitting outside hard-earned flats. Credit cards that will never again be flexed, and many pairs of cowboy boots that will no longer stride the King's Road. No one is supposed to say it, but their deaths seem all the more tragic, precisely because their lives were so fortunate.
At the time of our son's death, he'd been working as a supply teacher at a local school. Of course, there are also city high flyers, models and photographers. A successful, glamorous minority. But they were the minority. Among the others that died, there were packers, storemen, secretaries, caterers, art students and drama students. There were also builders, decorators, waiters, nurses and housewives. There were also a number of unemployed.
We have entrusted our brother Stephen to God's mercy, and we now commit his body to the ground.
For my family, the loss could not be greater.
Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
When we bury a father or a mother, we bury the past. When we bury a child, we bury the future.
And they may conform to his glorious body.
Francesca Delalio.
After all that, you decided on the jeans then?
Oh, perhaps it should have been the blue dress.
Francesca?
Hi.
Don't worry, Mrs. Delalio, I won't leave her side.
The Bow Belle was allowed to sail up and down the River Thames, even though the Ministry of Transport knew that the design of the Bow Belle totally obscured the forward view from the wheelhouse. The Bow Belle took on water as it went downriver. Its ballast hold would be a crucial aspect affecting forward vision. When it was virtually empty, as it was at the time it ran over and sank the Marchioness, the area of blindness for the helmsman in the bridge house at the rear of the ship was 1,480 feet, or 493 yards. Over a quarter of a mile of blindness to anything in front of her.
Woolwich radio, Bow Belle approaching Waterloo Bridge outwards.
The helmsman that night was Kenneth Noble. He later told one police officer that he'd not been drinking, and another that he'd not had a drink since 6 p.m. He also stated that he did not know the length or breadth of the ship he was steering. In the wheelhouse with Noble was the captain of the ship, Douglas Henderson, newly promoted to the rank of master a few months before the disaster. He had joined Ready Mixed Concrete in November 1987. 18 months earlier, Henderson had been fired by foreign ship owner Captain Ivar Vesterbotten. Reason for dismissal was for drinking and taking alcohol on board ship whilst in command of a vessel on the high seas. It was subsequently established that Henderson falsified parts of his maritime record. On the afternoon, and prior to returning to the Bow Belle, Henderson drank 6 pints of beer.
Hope you're not driving.
Not till I've had a kip. Just fill it up, man.
Henderson was tried twice on a charge of failing to keep a proper lookout and finally acquitted. The formal investigation found that he was not drunk on the night of the collision. Captain Henderson claimed that the lookout on duty that night was Terence Blaney, who had consumed 4 pints of beer and 4 pints of lager prior to the departure of the Bow Belle. Blaney has insisted since the disaster that he was not on lookout.
Out of the cook.
And he had never been given instruction by Captain Henderson as to his duty. The police did not board the Bow Belle until nearly 3 hours after the collision. They did not take a blood sample from Henderson or Helmsman Noble until 9 a.m., nearly 7 hours after the disaster. Blaney was not asked for a blood sample until 12 hours after the sinking of the Marchioness.
Andy, stick your head out and check a stern, would you?
This procedure passed for keeping a lookout on the Marchioness.
Oh, Dredger, it's right behind us! He's going to hit us!
The
Bow Belle had a history of at least 13 previous collisions on the Thames between 1965 and 1989.
Stephen John Perks.
The initial alarm was raised at 1:46 a.m. by the pleasure boat Hurlingham over VHF radio.
Bobbin, please, emergency. Pleasure boat is sunk. All emergency aid, please.
What happened after that moment was chaos and confusion, flowing from a response to a major disaster which fatally lacked a clear contingency plan. This failure was despite the fact that many, from Prime Minister Thatcher down, were on record as saying it was a disaster waiting to happen. Though a police launch from Wapping was in the disaster area in 5 minutes, their control was still attempting to clarify a definite location more than 8 minutes after the alert.
Pleasure boat sinking with 21 people on board. Chelsea embankment near Battersea Bridge.
Pleasure boat sunk in vicinity of Southwark Bridge.
A second boat entered the disaster area 7 minutes into the emergency, a third from the Waterloo Pier, having been alerted by a passing pleasure steamer, arrived after 9 minutes.
My God.
There was a 6 minute delay before Scotland Yard alerted the fire service, and at least a 9 minute delay before the Port of London Authority alerted fire control. 10 minutes is considered by professionals in the rescue services as the typical survival time in the Thames. The PLA control at Woolwich and the information room at Scotland Yard initially sent the emergency response in the wrong direction, advising the services that the collision had occurred upriver.
Battersea Bridge area, north side.
But Battersea Bridge instead of downriver in the region of Southwark Bridge.
What's up, Gov?
Someone's fucked up, mate. They've sent us the wrong way. The boat's downriver at Southwark Bridge, not here at Battersea. Go to Southwark.
The collision on the Thames occurred at 1:45 in the morning. The ambulance service claimed they were on the accident scene 10 minutes later. The Phoenix fireboat finally arrived in the correct area, nearly 30 minutes after the first alert. Of the 79 survivors, many either made their own way ashore or were rescued by the passengers and crew of the Hurlingham.
The fight by survivors and relatives of the victims to obtain a public inquiry lasted 10 years. It met continuing resistance from successive Conservative government ministers. On the 14th of February 2000, more than 10 years after the collision, Deputy Prime Minister John Prescott announced that there would be a full judicial inquiry into the Marchioness disaster.
After secret negotiations between lawyers acting for Ready Mix Concrete and the Attorney General, legal immunity was granted to the former crew of the Bow Belle and the directors and senior officers of the company. This immunity was extended to the owners of the Marchioness and ultimately to all witnesses. This ensured that none of them would have to face criminal proceedings if they agreed to testify at the inquiry. Lord Clark's formal investigation concluded that the collision was caused by a failure of both vessels to keep a proper lookout. He placed the responsibility on the master of the Bow Belle, Captain Henderson, the skipper of the Marchioness, the late Stephen Faldo, and the owners and managers of both boats, all of whom had been granted immunity from prosecution. No blame was attributed to any of the emergency services. No blame was attributed to the Ministry of Transport. No blame was attributed to the Port of London Authority.
51 people died on the River Thames on a calm, warm, moonlit night within half a mile of the Houses of Parliament, London's major hospitals, the headquarters of the Fire Brigade, and close to the River Police bases of Wapping and Waterloo. They died in the heart of the capital city of this country. 27 people escaped from the boat, yet still died, fighting for survival. At a second coroner's inquest in 1995, the jury's verdict was that all 51 victims had been unlawfully killed. No one has ever been found guilty of any crime or offence connected with these deaths. We lost our loved ones. We owe the victims something better than that. To the living, we owe respect. To the dead, we owe nothing but the truth.
Memories follow, force behind, the tide coming out. Many moons pass, the time connecting the shallow and the deep. Bridges of our hearts entwining, crossing over the edge. In the truth of our past,
we will save.